Coming up, we take a look at Windows Defender Application Guard, a new capability coming to Windows 10 Creators Update this fall to prevent browser-based attacks. I'll show you the user experience in Microsoft Edge when navigating to untrusted and trusted sites, how Windows Defender Application Guard leverages virtualization and Hyper-V to isolate the running processes from Windows, and how you can deploy and configure Application Guard in your organization. With Windows 10, we've considered the most common attacks against enterprises that we see today in the wild, from pre-breach defenses and post-breach containment. 90% of typical attacks come through phishing via links or malicious attachments in email, as well as watering hole attacks from sites that drop malicious payloads onto your machine. Attackers are moving down the stack. Historically, they focused on application-based attacks, though as Microsoft has invested in built-in defenses, such as application containers, to make user mode attacks more difficult, attackers are now focusing more on the kernel. Kernel-level exploits aim to gain system-level access, and we want to stop those attacks in their tracks. Windows Application Guard is a pre-breach defense that is part of the Windows Security Stack threat resistance. It's designed to stop these attacks and prevent data theft, espionage, and ransomware from affecting your organization. Let me walk you through a scenario of a typical attack where Application Guard is not present. Here, a user receives an email. Because it looks legitimate, they click on it. Even though it's from an untrusted source, it's still loaded and looked fine to the user. The goal of the attacker is to exploit the PC before the user realizes they are attacked, and they are redirected to a legitimate website, but in reality, it contained a dangerous exploit. You might not have noticed what happened, but if we play the page load back in slow motion and focus on the address bar, you'll notice the URL redirecting from the attacker website. Now let me show you the same attack with Application Guard protecting the PC. Here the site opens with Microsoft Edge, and you can see that Application Guard is enabled here on the left. Same as before, the exploit runs, but it's isolated in a container and the host machine is protected. That's because Edge is running in a Hyper-V-based container that is isolated from the host kernel and user mode in the PC, which neutralizes the exploit. All the processes executing in Edge are located in a container that is not connected to the host. Anything that runs in the container stays in the container. The container is also blocked from accessing internal network resources, adding an additional layer of defense. Because we use container technology, we can leverage a much smaller footprint than a full virtual machine. There are two ways that Application Guard can be launched. The first way is for the user to launch Application Guard from the Edge menu like you would do for in private browsing. Once you see the orange Application Guard label in the upper left corner of the Edge browser, you know that you're browsing in isolation. Users can access Edge features such as printing and clipboard and Application Guard just like you can do on the host, all of which can be controlled using group policy. The second way is what we call enterprise mode. Like we just saw, this mode is where the administrator has configured management policy to automatically open untrusted sites in Application Guard. As we can see here, the administrator has enabled Application Guard in enterprise mode. Enterprise mode is available in Windows 10 Enterprise, and with this enabled, untrusted sites will always open with Edge and Application Guard. In the enterprise, you can enable enterprise mode via Group Policy, Configuration Manager, or Intune. Each can configure the settings required to enable Application Guard for your managed PCs. Here I have Group Policy Editor open, and you can see the policies I need to configure under Administrative Templates, Windows Components. Here I can enable Application Guard and configure clipboard and print settings. To configure what sites are allowed to open in Edge on the host OS, you add them in Administrative Templates under Network Isolation Policy. From here, you'll configure the following policies for trusted sites: private network ranges for apps, domains categorized as both work and personal, and enterprise resource domains hosted in the cloud. Application Guard is a hardware-based endpoint defense. It's the last but most powerful line of defense to protect your business. It complements technologies like Office 365 or Windows Advanced Threat Protection, and detected exploits are passed to those services. In addition, Application Guard has integration with Windows Defender ATP, which allows the container to send ATP events to Windows Defender Security Center to help detect current attacks as well as contain future attacks on other systems. If an attack is detected, the details will be reported in the Windows Defender Security Center console, as shown here. So that was a quick tour of Windows Defender Application Guard, a new capability coming to Windows 10 Creators Update this fall. You can try it for yourself by enrolling in Windows Insiders. Thanks for watching.